Hello. So, Oscar season is here again. I know I've talked about the Oscars a few times on this channel. Or maybe it was just once, and I might have briefly mentioned something later on another date. But basically, they're here again, and there's a decent amount of movies nominated, you know, or at least decent movies that are nominated. Hacksaw Ridge, and Mel Gibson's movie got nominated for Best Picture. Garfield is nominated for Best Actor, and Mel Gibson himself was nominated for Best Director. I was a little shocked and delighted because, you know, I mean, there's all that stuff about Mel Gibson for many years. It's like if you work with him, you're kind of like tainted. At least that's what it kind of like. There was like some sort of stigma about him, at least. But at least, you know, he's being acknowledged for like the first time in a long time, and you know, I say good. You know, he said some things in the past that, you know, he clearly regrets. You know, he's had anger problems, he's had drinking problems, and you know, after all this time, it's like, you know, been about a decade of him being sort of ostracized by Hollywood, and I'm glad. I think this is kind of coming to an end. Yes, he's made a mistake, but let's be honest, everyone's made some mistakes. Some they have done, some they may not have done, but you know, got blamed, and you know, there may be some baggage from that. This kind of goes into what I'm going to be talking about. But I will say, like other films such as La La Land, 14 Oscar nominations. You know, it's really a shame that the Academy really didn't like that movie. I mean, I haven't seen it yet, but you know, I'm interested in seeing it. Fences, Denzel Washington nominated. Looked really good. Viola Davis is nominated. Like to see her win. But, you know, who knows. Manchester by the Sea. I did a little thing about that not that long ago. So how much I really like it. You know, Casey Affleck's nominated. I'm glad. Michelle Williams too. Screenplay, direction nominated. It's nominated for Best Picture. It's nominated for Supporting Actor for Lucas. Oh, what's his? Great, I'm blanking on his name. You know, Manchester by the Sea, Casey Affleck is what I kind of want to talk about today. You know, apparently there's some controversy because when I did my review of Manchester by the Sea, I didn't talk about a particular thing, which was this incident in 2010 in which Casey Affleck was, he went to court for sexually harassing two women on the film. He worked on, it was a movie called I'm Not There, or I'm Still Here. I'm Still Here. It's directed by him. It stars himself as well as Joaquin Phoenix, who also directed the movie. And they also wrote it together. It's a mockumentary, basically. You know, if you haven't seen it, you know, I'd say give it a watch. Basically, Joaquin Phoenix kind of trolled everybody by saying he will forever quit acting and be a rapper from that moment forward. And then you see him trying to become a rapper, basically. So, while Affleck got a well-deserved Oscar nomination for Manchester by the Sea, this woman, Constance Wu, it's an article from a website called Vulture. I've never heard of it before. But apparently, she's disgusted by Casey Affleck's Oscar nomination. Art isn't about humanity, right? And the article goes, it's written by some woman, Hallie Kiefer. Again, don't know who she is. But it goes as followed. As anticipated, Casey Affleck received a Best Actor Academy Award nomination for Manchester by the Sea this morning. The news served as evidence that some multiple allegations of sexual harassment against him in a related lawsuit have been successfully swept under the rug, at least in the case in the Academy's eyes. Affleck has previously denied all allegations against him, and still suits out of court of an undisclosed sum. Fresh off the boat, actress Constance Wu, I've never seen that, is not about to let the viewing public forget about the accusations against Affleck, who is now being celebrated for his talent. Men who sexually harass women for Oscar, because good acting performance matters more than humanity, human integrity, because poor kid really needs the help, the actress tweeted sardonically. In a longer post, she expounds further. He's running for an award that honors a craft whose purpose is examining the dignity of human experience, and young women are deeply human. Wu calls on voting organizations to recognize their role in condoning award recipients' actions. It signifies said community's awareness of the harmful oversights it may have unknowingly participated in the past, and respect the indignity and learn from the past, not to repeat it and not to use it as an excuse to reinforce the industry's gross and often hidden mistreatment of women. Wu concludes by acknowledging that she's been told not to speak about the matter. I've been counseled not to talk about this for my career's sake. F my career, then. I am a woman and human first. That's what my craft is built on. So, yeah. That's really it. I mean, there's this other stuff, but I'm not completely sure what this pertains to. I'm sure it has to do with Affleck, but and it also talks about her, and he's not running for president and stuff, and I'm like, what? Basically, my thought is this, and I wrote this in a comment because I want to share my thoughts, but you had to kind of make up some kind of, you know, make up an account, and I did that just to write this one little thing. And basically what I said was, you know, sexual harassment allegations. This was in 2010, 2009 maybe, and I have to say that we're bringing this up now because he's up for an award. He was up for many awards, really now, so it's the appropriate time to do this. Look, I'm just going to say this. We don't know whether or not he actually sexually harassed these two women, because there's there's a case. You can go look at all the documents and stuff. And I have, and one woman said that he went around the set. He's like, one's a producer, one's like the director of photography. Like the producer, I believe, said he went around saying women were cows. And he let some guy show himself to her. Like Affleck, just as a director, just let that happen. Like he tug off his pants and just, let her see everything he had, and, I mean, that's not good, obviously, but, it's an allegation. That's important to remember. And then, he went around on the set saying they were cows, huh? I'm actually shocked that all these people that were on the movie, I'm sure people heard him say that. I'm shocked they still worked on the movie, unless everybody on there was just sexist. And, there were, she, said that he, they shared an apartment with, Joaquin Phoenix, and Affleck let her use, he let her use his bedroom to sleep in for a night, because I guess there was a night where she didn't have a place to go and stay, like a hotel or anything, so, like, for the night, she was gonna stay there. Well, apparently, he got in bed with her in his underwear. He was, like, just like, holding her and, like, stroking her back, and then his breath smelled of alcohol. I believe I'm remembering all this right. Basically, he touching on them and making advances on them. Wasn't there anyone around? I'm sure some of this all happened on the set, right? I mean, if he's calling women cows, I'm sure other people have said it. Unless he took one of these women aside and then was talking about them, the women in general, and was using the word cow. I don't know, it sounds a little iffy to me. There's a lot of people on here that don't obviously like him now because of these sexual harassment allegations. And they often bring up this guy who made a movie this year also, His name was Nate Parker, and I read about him, and apparently he and a friend, like, gang raped, like, or took turns raping this one woman. And, he was, arrested and charged with this. He got acquitted, but his friend went to jail. And now they're all saying how it's like a race thing, too. And my thought is, no. The charge was really bad for Nate Parker. He got charged for raping a woman. Casey Affleck was not charged. He wasn't charged. He had allegations of sexual harassment from two women. It's also interesting that you never heard anyone else on the set complain. I mean, if these two women did, why wouldn't anyone else do it? From the sounds of it, he was just disrespecting women, calling them names. Probably from the way they say it, he would just try to just do things sexually, just to, get in their pants. And the whole thing was settled out of court. And after that, really nothing was ever said of that. You didn't hear anything from those women. And from all that, I mean, if you were actually sexually harassed, if women were sexually harassed in this environment, you would have thought they would want to make sure things would be in place for, like, movies, that there will be consequences for those who, sexually harass anybody, man or woman, no matter what your position is, whether you're the director or the actor or whatever. Casey Affleck was both of those on that film, so that's why I used those as an analogy. And to compare somebody's alleged sexual harassment with somebody's charged rape is just, I don't think that's a good comparison at all. I mean, really? If you're gonna do that, like, if you're gonna do anything in this situation, which they keep referring to Nate Parker, one could possibly compare what he did to Roman Polanski. Roman Polanski raped like a 13-year-old girl, and things like where he drugged her, or no, he didn't drug her and she wanted it, but no matter what, because she wasn't 18, it's rape no matter what. And he got, he was charged, they were arrested, was charged. They said he was going to serve time, and it seemed like he was going to do it. But before a date was, like, set for him to go and start his sentencing, he fled America and never came back. Though Nate Parker never did this, but, they were both charged with rape. Casey Affleck is not. Was not charged with rape. He was accused of sexually harassing two women, which, yes, while it is bad, is it on the same level as rape? That's my question, and I don't believe it is. He didn't rape anyone. And you know what? Maybe Casey Affleck did actually sexually harass these women. And you know, if that's the case, well, then that's very, you know, that's very bad, and it's not good. But since no big deal from this was ever made afterwards, after the women got their money that was eventually given to them, since, you know, it was set on court, do we need to vilify Affleck now? You know, he's gotten a Critics' Choice Award and a Golden Globe. He's up for a BAFTA. Up for a Screen Actors Guild. Up for an Academy Award. Must we bring personal lives into the Academy's decision? The people who judge the acting, they're to judge his performance. Is his performance the best out of the year and the best out of the other four nominees? That's their job. So do we have to throw that in there too? Do we need to see? Do we really need to do that? And you know, Roman Polanski won an Academy Award for Best Director in The Pianist. And, you know, no matter what side of the argument of him raping somebody, some say he didn't, some say he did. I saw The Pianist, and I, you know, when he won the Academy Award for Best Director, I'm like, you know, as much as, you know, as I might not like what he did, it's really sad this, you know, and he admitted to doing it, but I guess perhaps when you're in that position, you might as well just say, yeah, that way you can get it over with quickly, but clearly he didn't do that. Personally, from what I've read, I do believe he did rape that woman. He won an Academy Award for The Pianist. And I don't think that Oscar should be taken away from him, because that year he did deserve it, in my opinion. You might not agree with that, and that's okay. But we need to look at their work, and we need to look at their work in that film, that specific film they're nominated, and not bring their personal life into it. This happened to Casey Affleck like 6-7 years ago. We need to bring this up now because he's up for an award. Come on. Let's. You know, those sexual harassment allegations. It was never confirmed or anything like that. There was never an instance where he got charged. You know. They sell out of court. End of story, whether you agree with that or not. And, you know, it's not like he forced one of these women to have sex with him. And also, one of these women, the producer, I believe, like, yeah, she said he had sex with a bunch of women in her hotel room and locked her out of her hotel room. Okay. But because, you know, they're just, it's really weird. And, you know, I wrote a comment, which essentially was what I said to you all right here. And there's a comment here that's just, really means wow. Which was, person says, I'm 100% behind repeatedly making public any and all wrongful acts committed by a famous person, whether it be sexual harassment, sexual assault, or otherwise. Public shaming is completely acceptable to me and is one of the principal ways we can affect private conduct and promote acceptance of appropriate norms of behavior. However, an Oscar, an Emmy, a Pulitzer, a Nobel Prize for chemistry, or any other award given for excellence in a particular field should not be denied a person simply on account whether that person has violated a criminal law, has been found civilly liable for damages, has settled a civil suit, or has been accused of violating criminal or civil law. Someone can be an excellent writer, actor, director, chemist, physicist, whose contributions to such field are worthy of esteem despite his or her private conduct. To the extent the accusations against Affleck are true, and I have no reason to believe they aren't, and I am glad this moment in the spotlight is clouded by the renewed discussion of his alleged reprehensible conduct, but his acting in Manchester by the Sea was incredible and is deserving all the praise he receives. And, yeah, it's... And this kind of... There's some little... thing. And then this other user says, I think she means worthy of esteem and deserving of praise, can't be taken away. No one debates Casey Affleck is a talented actor, and he has been more than lauded for his work here and other films. It shouldn't be validated and decorated by an institution that has ignored in the past for more problematic reasons. #OscarSoWhite was only last year. This would be an opportunity for the Academy to take a step towards rewriting the narrative of the white male redemption tours that have been afforded to the Mel Gibsons and Woody Allens and Brad Pitts, but not the Nate Parkers. I'm not saying all their transgressions are one and the same, or that people shouldn't get Oscars because of outstanding parking tickets or whatever, but her point might have been it would have made a more valuable statement for the Academy to pass on this one. And these two other people. This one guy, strong one, says, Nick Parker needs no redemption. 20 years ago, he went to court, faced his accusers, who testified and sat at the judgment of an all-white jury. Okay, he was acquitted. But that didn't matter, or that didn't seem to matter to those who are now defending Casey Affleck's well-known and recent and amply documented history of sexual harassment. Huh. He settled where there was no chance, so there wouldn't be a chance of his facing Nate Parker's fate. Okay, well, is well-known and amply documented history of sexual harassment. From my knowledge, this incident during the making of that film was the only one. If there is any more, I have not heard of it. I have not seen any other documents of it, except from these two women. And then this guy, VidFrost1, is basically responding to the user of the original post with all these comments, which is, you need to feed into that big black internet hole of media abuse when you go on about things like this. Unless I was there responding later to something I saw with my own eyes or had access to all the court facts, I'm gonna keep my effing mouth shut. Because truth is, I don't really know what happened or why. When I read a sentence like, to the extent of accusations against Affleck are true, and I have no reason to believe they aren't, then I'm glad at this moment and the spotlight is clouded by the renewed decision of his alleged reprehensible conduct. I wonder why no reason to believe they aren't. I could say the exact opposite. I have no reason to believe they are true. So there. Do you really think your reasoning is infallible? Sorry. We have just gone through an election in the United States that was manipulated by some degree by unsupported news stories. Just think of it. All those people on the internet spreading the Clinton child sex ring deal are unwittingly doing Russia's dirty work. I have no reason to believe they aren't. It's just not good enough. Affleck's alleged harassment comes out of a civil case. Affleck was not arrested. There was no prosecution. Interestingly enough, nowhere on the internet is there any mention from others working on or around I'm Still Here on bad behavior, on or off the record. I do not condone sexual harassment or abuse of any kind. But before I go on a crusade against someone who's been publicly accused, I would have to know that the facts are solid. I'm not okay with this sort of unsubstantiated character attack on the internet, and I agree with that guy. I'm sorry, I thought I was about to go in a coughing attack. But yeah, anyway, you know, no one else said anything negative about his behavior. It's just these two women, and it's like, and the second one came after some time after the first one, so I'm sure one of them heard this and then just thought they'd want to get him on the action too. That's asserting that it is fake, that these stories are fake and never happened. Is I'm very, very inclined to believe it. It's not because I'm a white man or anything. It's because, you know, there isn't really solid evidence to support that he actually did sexually harass these women. There's only two women, and it's their word. They have no other people to back up that he called her women pit cows, or that some guy let out his penis in front of him. Just all this stuff that they have, and I'm sure there are things I didn't mention here, and I apologize, but you know, you can look it up on, you can Google it, and it's just, it's just very convenient, you know, that this comes back to light after he gets acclaimed in a movie and starts getting awards and nominations for possibly more wins of this award. And, you know, I'm just not totally buying he sexually assaulted these women. But if they are true, well then, you know, shame on Casey Affleck. But because if news breaks that this was all true and not just word say with no actual real liable sources, You know, it's... Does that mean he doesn't deserve an Academy Award for his amazing performance in Manchester by the Sea? I would like to see him win. And that's because of his acting. He was really good. I feel he is the best actor of last year. You might think maybe Denzel Washington is better, or Andrew Garfield, or Ryan Gosling, or Viggo Mortensen, you know, many of the other nominees. Or maybe you wanted someone else to be nominated, but, you know, they just didn't make the cut. The point I'm trying to make is let's not just go on in this, say, this person doesn't deserve this award because of what he might have done in his past. He might have done this, but there's not strong enough evidence to conclude he actually did harass these women sexually. So with that, I do not believe he should be penalized and his chances of winning an Academy Award should be taken away from him. I don't think so. We need to focus on the work of this guy in this respect, in this certain category. They gave it to Roman Polanski for Best Director, and he, you know, raped a 13-year-old girl. But even with that reprehensible act that he did, his work on The Pianist was amazing, and I do believe he was deserving of that Oscar. Nate Parker, he did a movie this year. I haven't seen it, but, you know, people said it was good. But maybe it wasn't that good to get nominated for an Oscar or two. But again, I haven't seen it, so if I do, I might think it should have. But Affleck was accused of sexually harassing two women, with not enough evidence except for the word of these two women, and he should be penalized and not get an award if he actually deserves it and was the actual best actor of that year. I don't think he should be penalized for that. I feel if some Academy voters don't vote for him, it should be because they thought one of the other nominees was genuinely better, not because of how people view Casey Affleck. You know, that's what I would say to the Academy. We need to judge him on the film, judge his performance. If we believe that it's truly the best, we give it to him. We vote for him. And if the votes count up and he is the winner, we give it to him. But if we count up the votes and he is not, doesn't have the most, okay, we give it to who does. That's fair in my opinion. You might not like my opinion, maybe because it has, you know, logic, but, you know, in today's age, of all this trying to be like social justice warriors and all that, that's just, it needs to stop. And then this Clinton sex or child sex ring thing was weird. I thought it was, I mean, I agree with the point of him about Affleck and his allegations and how no one, you know, else except for those two said he didn't have, never mentioned any bad behavior about him at all. So, something. And basically, except that Russian Clinton child sex thing, all that, I actually wrote a comment on here that said something similar. That was me saying how he was actually, you know, just accused of sexually harassing these two women and didn't actually And I guess there wasn't enough evidence to make it to charge him with this, and then have a big trial for the whole thing. Judge him for his performance, not because of what he may have done. I've said that before, but this is a case where I feel, I guess, it needs to be repeated. And I know this was a long video, and I apologize, but I hope my point got across. Thanks for watching.